Even with the summer driving season in the rearview mirror, gas prices remain near record highs, averaging $3.66 a gallon nationwide. That's nearly a dollar more than a year ago. So what's driving up pump prices? Here's Hattie Kaufman.
Americans may have gotten the day off from work, but they're not getting a break at the pump.
Just upset. I just feel down when I'm getting gas. No one wants to, you know, fill up your tank for $70.
In Los Angeles, Rachel Wilcox has reason to be angry. The price of gas has risen for 18 straight days in California, from $3.72 to $3.94 a gallon for regular.
Came today to see that the prices went up. I should have done it yesterday.
U.S. refinery shutdowns because of Hurricane Irene and Tropical Storm Lee were partly responsible for the recent gas hike. But the heart of the problem is the chaos in Libya. Analyst Tom Closeau monitors the oil and gas industry.
Well, losing Libya was probably the number one reason why we have high prices this year. It's the light, sweet crude that everyone needs.
Another factor driving gasoline prices even higher is that U.S. refineries are now exporting 500,000 barrels a day of gasoline and diesel overseas.
Over the last 10 weeks, for the first time in decades, we are exporting more refined products than we're importing.
That's because of increased demand in South and Central America. All of it is exasperating to driver Monty Maccabee.
We pay farmers not to grow crops. We export gasoline. It seems like a messed up situation, and no one can find a job.
There may be some relief in the weeks ahead as cheaper winter-grade gas starts making its way to the pumps. That alone could drop prices by 15 cents a gallon. Hattie Kaufman, CBS News, Los Angeles.